around the left side, hit at the 20, and brought down around the 23-yard line.
Yeah, pretty good return there for Chris Hall, just giving himself and the Gretna Hawks offense good start and position. You know, Gretna have really run the ball well the past few weeks, and like you said, it was dating back to the Alta Vista game. So I think we'll see a steady dose of that here early on, test this Blacksburg defense.
Okay, going to start in the I formation with two receivers. Rosser will be under center. Chambers is the deep back. And here's a handoff to Chambers. Chambers goes left side, pushes ahead across the 25. And it'll be second down. Right at the 25, so second down and 8. Only got 2 there, and pretty good play on that defensive front there by the Bruins.
Yeah, I believe Grunda's going to have to go to the stretch play and run the ball to the outside on this Blacksburg defense.
All right, we'll go back to the spread now, and Rosser from the shotgun will hand it off to Chambers. Chambers, not much there. He got ahead for about 3. Had to avoid a couple of tacklers in order to do that.
And I believe Gretna would have been more suffice to have Deion Rosser run the ball there, because on that read option play, he got to look off the defensive end, and if the defensive end does not commit to you, you can go around the edge and you'll have pretty good yardage right there. And for Gretna, they didn't do it right there.
All right, third down and about 5. Rosser from the shotgun, 2 receivers right and 1 to the left. And Rosser straight drop, quick throw over. It's complete, but maybe short.
Yeah, I believe they're going to be just short of the first down. And number 1, Corbin Hendricks in on a tackle for the Bruins. So a big decision time here for the Gretna Hawks. Do they go for it right here, or do they try to punt it away?
It comes up about a yard short. I believe Virgil Glass was the one who caught that, but he's a yard short. But we've got the offense in the game, and the Bruins sending off, I guess that was their punt return team. And they're 4th and 1, and the Hawks are going to go for it. And it's going to be Rosser with the first down over the left side. He got about 4 out to the 36-yard line.
And that's just one offensive line outwilling the defensive line for Blacksburg. And I believe this defensive line for Blacksburg is pretty young. This whole team for Blacksburg is pretty young. They do have a couple seniors on the team, but you know, it's mostly sophomores and juniors on this team.
And the Hawks pick up that first down on 4th down, and there is Chambers this time. Not able to get through the line. He was able to push ahead for a couple. And again, the Hawks very conservative on their play calling here. And you can see Rosser with his hands in his warmer. They got the warmers on tonight, and they're trying to keep those hands warm out there, Eric.
Yeah, and Rosser's going to need to keep his hand warm. You know, he could still have a little remnants of the injury from last week, but I really doubt it. They'll probably go to the air here on 2nd and long.
All right, 2nd down, 2nd and 7, we'll call it, a long 7. And Rosser is going to give it off. He keeps it on the option. Only got about 2 out to the 40-yard line. He looked like he was going to give it to Chambers, but he pulled it back and went ahead for 2. And it'll be 3rd, and we'll call it 3rd and 6.
You know, I'd really expect for Gretna to be hitting the outside of this Blacksburg line, because Blacksburg has a 6'5", 285 senior, Adam Petten, on the defensive tackle spot.
All right. Just under 9 minutes to go in the first quarter. Hawks have it 3rd and 6. Rosser is going to be sacked. Could not get out of the backfield. He tried to get out of there, and somebody got him by the ankle, and it'll be 4th down.
That was number 1, Corbin Hendricks, again on the tackle, and it's going to be 4th and long here, excuse me, for the Hawks. They're going to bring on Kinnear to punt.
All right, 4th and 9, 4th down play. So the Bruins have held here, and pending the outcome of this kick, could get pretty good field position.
And back deep for the Bruins is number 6, Morgan McCoy, the 5'7" sophomore.
10 men on the line. Here's the kick. He gets it low and out of there, and it's going to be rolling right along one of the Gretna defenders, and it'll be down by number 30. I believe that's Stone for Gretna, who downs it at the 33.
Yeah, Raekwon Stone downs it at the 33. So Blacksburg is going to take over 1st and 10. You know, they're led by 2 sophomores on offense, and they're led by their starting quarterback Isaac Johnston and their star wide receiver Morgan McCoy, who last week against Salem, McCoy and Johnston combined together to throw for 105 yards. And, you know, McCoy, he had the touchdown, so he's going to be the go-to receiver here for the Bruins tonight.
All right, first and 10, blitz coming, and they're going to try to catch number one. He breaks a tackle, gets out of the backfield, and gets a pretty good game on that.
Yeah, Corbin Hendricks again on the run. He's everywhere here tonight on the field. And he got a pretty good run, and he was a shoestring tackle away from breaking that for a touchdown.
All right, so a gain of 7, and Hawks win the backfield, but give Hendricks credit for dancing around and getting away. And after they blitzed like that, there was nobody behind to track him down, but somebody did get him and bring him down. All right, here's quarterback rolling right, throws on the run, complete, and tackle made at the 40-yard line. Nice looking run and catch, throw and catch there, throw and run. Down to the 40, number 85, I believe, on that.
Number 85.
I thought it was 85. Yeah, Jack Hale.
Jack Hale.
And Bruins look sharp here. Two plays, they're already at the Gretna 40-yard line.
And this doesn't look like a sophomore-led team.
Quarterback number 5, Isaac Johnston, takes the shotgun snap. Pressure comes, he throws quickly and dropped. Right in the hands of his intended receiver, number 16.
That'd be number 16, Everett Vick. And, you know, he should be a shorthanded wide receiver. He's a senior, so your senior leadership has to stand up here, and that's a big game.
Yeah, kind of just getting ready to run it before you catch it deal and dropped it. And it'll be second and 10 for the Bruins. We are 7:23 to go in the first quarter. No score from Blacksburg as the Hawks and Bruins get together here tonight. Shotgun formation, 3 receivers left side, 1 to the right. Quarterback keeper, number 5, is not able to get around the end. He'll be stacked up at the line of scrimmage. And he'd been better off to hand that one off, I think. Johnston decided to keep it, and he paid the price.
Yeah, he paid a big price there. And that Gretna defensive line, and I believe one of the linebackers laid the lumber on him right there.
All right, third down and 9. He did managed to get one, I don't know how. But third and 9 now for the Bruins.
And if you're Gretna here, you need a big stop, and you got to keep the points off the board if you are the Gretna defense.
All right, third and 9. And going from the shotgun again, looks like one receiver right, one in the slot right, and he's looking right, throws across the middle, caught, and not sure he hung on to it. They ruled it complete. And we have 2 injured players.
You got a Gretna Hawk player and a Blacksburg player down.
All right, it was a hard hit on the catch. And both a Hawk player and the receiver are still down. And it was like a helmet to chest sort of deal. Maybe the under the chin as well. Number 10, I believe, the receiver.
Yeah, Josh Williams.
It will be a first down.
Yeah, Josh Williams down for the Bruins. And I'm not sure who is down for the Hawks.
Not sure yet either. And they'll have to attend to both of them. Coach Saunders is there looking at his player. Trying to get up, but he's in a lot of pain, and he's going to try to get up, but he lays back down.
And number 10, Josh Williams, is up for the Bruins, so that's a good sign. He's running off on his own power, so that's a really good sign.
He's going to be okay, but we're not sure about our injured Hawk at this point. We'll have an injury timeout. Seminole Sunoco Food Mart, Highway 29 south of Gretna, is proud to sponsor Taylor. Is proud to sponsor Gretna Hawks football and is open till 11 o'clock on Friday nights. And, of course, Sunoco gas is available 24/7 as well, including diesel and non-ethanol gas, pizza by the slice for $2.69 or the whole pizza, just $8.99. Or go by in the morning. Seminole Sunoco Food Shop has grab-and-go breakfast biscuits, pastries, coffee, cappuccino, smoothies, and more. That's the Seminole Sunoco Food Mart, Highway 29, south of Gretna. Injured player for Gretna was number 15, Taylor, who finally does get up and go off the field, but he was a little bit wobbly, Eric.
Yeah, he was a little bit wobbly. And right now we got a sideline warning against Gretna before the play starts. Not sure what went on.
All right, Coach Saunders is over there having some kind of discussion with the official, and I'm still not sure what the infraction was other than did they actually throw the flag there?
They actually threw the flag, so I don't think they ran off any time.
All right, first and 10 at the 24-yard line. Nice drive here by the Bruins here with 6:12 to go in the first quarter. Quarterback throws and dropped again, trying to run before the catch. Number 3, the intended receiver. I'm pretty impressed with Blacksburg's short throwing game here. The Hawks are going to have to play a little bit better pass defense or either get more pressure on the quarterback.
Yeah, Ethan Goforth, just missed the ball right there. But, you know, this passing offense is really working here for the Bruins, and they're moving the ball on the Gretna Hawk defense. And if I'm looking correctly, the Gretna Hawk defense, they're not even looking at the receiver. They're looking at the quarterback. They're looking to see what his eyes are doing, where he's going with the ball.
All right, shotgun snap. Here's a handoff. Number 1, this time, they'll wrap him up. He might have got a yard in there. That was Hendricks.
And they're really opening up some good lines for the running back to run through here, but 3rd and 9 here for the Bruins.
Hawks coming up with some injuries here lately. Bennett went out last week. We just had Taylor injured, and I think one of the linemen just went out maybe with a limp a little bit as well. So we'll see if Gretna might take a timeout here, and they will. They will take it too. Blacksburg has 3rd down and 9 when we come back. You're listening to Gretna Hawks football on ESPN Radio. You know they got a good kicker here. They got a good soccer program.
Standing about 70 across the way. Estimate 70-80. It looked like that many, but when you start counting by it,
yeah.
And they're huddled together.
Bathroom is at the concession stand.
I see Joe.
No, I didn't get a chance.
I tried to get through that concession stand, and don't get late for it. We went through it.
No
one to the concession.
Yeah.
They let y'all do it?
They didn't stop us.
It smelled good. I wanted to stop.
And welcome back. On 3rd and down, they go for the end zone, but just overthrows number 3 for Blacksburg.
Yeah, he just overthrows his wide receiver, Ethan Goforth. If Ethan Goforth is 6 foot, he makes that catch, but he's 5'8", so he's not going to make that catch.
All right, then they'll go for the field goal here. Blacksburg is has a great soccer program here. You know they got good kickers.
Yeah, number 8, Carson Wise, is on to kick for the Bruins. 5'10", 154 senior.
39-yard attempt.
And he's going to kick this straight away, not soccer style.
All right, here's a kick. Has the distance. May have went. It's good. It went right through there. All right, went on the left side, but inside of the post, and the Bruins take the early 3-0 lead with 5:19 to go in the first quarter. Number 8 on that kick was
Carson Wise.
Carson Wise, good from 39. Let's take a timeout. You're listening to Gretna Hawks football on ESPN Radio. The names on the backs of the jerseys.
Yep.
They're sponsored by Under Armour too.
Yeah. Hello? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. All right. Yeah, I'll try to. We're sitting differently. I'll try to get the phone over closer to him. Snuggle. Okay. All right. Okay. Thank you for that. Hey, welcome back. 5:19 to go. Bruins on the board with a 39-yard field goal. They lead 3-0. And we're set for the kick.
back deep is Keandre Clements and Chris Hall.
This is a high kick taken at the two. Hall goes up the left side, cuts back to the middle. Now will be corralled around the 29-yard line. Pretty good run by Chris Hall.
Yeah, pretty good return there by Chris Hall. But I believe if he comes over to this near side, the right side, I believe he has a shot to take that one back to the house for six.
All right, so the Hawks will start at the right at the 30-yard line, and first and 10. We'll see if they can do better and try to open things up. They tried to go mainly with the running game, and the Bruins were pretty good on defense. So first and 10 for the Hawks, their second possession, trailing 3-0. Hall comes in motion, high snap, Rosser to keep, and he's caught, gets maybe a yard, and that's it. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage.
And I believe if he didn't have the high snap right there, the give would have been to Chris Hall, but as soon as the ball got to Rosser there, he was unable to get the ball to Hall.
All right, a high snap, and we've had some issues with that from time to time, and that was the case right there. Hawks look a little flat, though, Eric, here. I don't know if it's the weather, the tough
ride.
Game last week, or what. They look like they're a little sleep right now.
Could have been the long ride over here,
yeah.
Also.
Yep. All right, second down. Hall in motion again. This time Hall gets it, and they catch him in the backfield. He gets away from one and is only able to get to the 29. This Blacksburg defense is playing strong right now, getting back into the backfield and breaking up that sweep play right there.
Yeah, that was number six, Morgan McCoy, the outside linebacker, in on the tackle right there. And, you know, Gretna, they're really going to have to go to the air here because Blacksburg's defense has been shutting down the run. They know what Gretna's
yeah,
good at.
That's what I'm thinking. They are definitely keying on what we normally do. Third and 10. Two receivers to the left side, one to the right. And here comes pressure. Throw over the middle. It's complete but short. That was Virgil Glass with a catch. He stretches, but he's going to still be 3 yards short.
And I'm not really liking what I'm seeing here with the Gretna offense
yep.
early. You know, they're stalled on two straight drives, going three and out, I believe, on two straight drives.
They converted a fourth down, and other than that, that's it. So they'll punt again. And this time Blacksburg is going to back off. They sent 10 men on the first one. This time they're going to back off a little bit and maybe set up for a return.
You got McCoy back deep for the Bruins at his own 32-yard line.
All right. No pressure. Kick kind of wobbles out of there. Fair catch called for at the 40-yard line.
And he is lucky he called for the fair catch yep. right there because he would have got smacked by Jeremiah Chambers. But the Bruins are going to take over first and 10 at their own 41-yard line.
All right. And 3:05 to go in the first quarter. Bruins lead it 3-0. And they have the ball back on offense. And we'll see if this Gretna defense can get things going here in this first quarter. Again, 3:05 to go in the first quarter. Blacksburg will operate, looks like offset eye, quarterback under center, and here's the handoff to the tailback. He breaks through and gets caught at about the 46-yard line, and that was a high tackle that if he was able to break, he's got a lot of room to run.
Yeah, he's got nothing but real estate in front of him on that one, and he would have been taking that one down I-85 for a touchdown.
All right, second and four, gain of six. And good situation here for the Bruins on second down. They got the short passing game going, and they're running the ball pretty well, too. Quarterback will operate from the shotgun, looking to pass. And throw underneath is caught by number 85. Comes down the sideline, dances along, breaking tackles, and finally will be caught at the 21-yard line. And again, some poor tackling. And really, the Hawks did not have enough defenders to cover all the receivers on this left side.
Yeah, 37-yard pass there. And Jack Hale, just using his brute force to break the tackles, all the arm tackles that the Gretna defense is trying to put on him.
2:10 to go, and the Bruins trying to build an early lead here, and they're looking good doing it. First and 10 at the 21-yard line. Again, the Hawks are definitely flat tonight. Give some credit to the Bruins for that as well. From the I formation, hand off to the fullback, pushes the pile straight forward. They stand him up finally after a gain of about four. And second down and 6 coming up. Hawks need a spark, Eric, and they need something, a turnover or something to get them going here.
In the first couple games of the season, they had a turnover in every game, and I don't believe that they've really had a turnover that much in the past couple games, and they desperately need one here with Blacksburg inside of the red zone here at the 18-yard line.
All right, second and 6. Quarterback under center, he's got... two running backs, got a handoff number 1, left side ahead for a couple, maybe 3.
Yeah, Hendricks, I'm really liking what I'm seeing from Hendricks. He's finding the hole and he's hitting it hard, but you know, it's really taking a toll on the Gretna interior defensive line and their linebackers, and they really have to respect the run as well as the pass because Blacksburg is very balanced here tonight.
And Blacksburg running players in and out, I guess for different packages they use. Now they're going to go to a spread formation, 3rd and 4. And there'll be 2 receivers to the right, 1 to the left. And quarterback looking to throw, looking for the end zone, lays it up. And outstretched, but out of bounds. Nice catch, but he was out of the end zone by about a yard.
That was Jake Verniel, and you know he made the effort to get his toes down for the catch. And just a little outstretched. And a little overthrown by Isaac Johnston. But now you're going to have the kicker, Carson Wise, come on again. This is going to be about a 32-yarder.
Yeah, from the left hash, so it's not straight on. And he'll go with a soccer style on this one. Interesting. 2 different styles of kicking by 1 kicker. Snap is good, the kick on the way. And I believe he put it through.
And I believe it is
It is good. Hawks are lucky to be trailing just 6-0. Because it's been all Blacksburg here in the first quarter. 23 seconds remaining, and it's Blacksburg 6, Gretna nothing. We'll take a timeout. You're listening to Gretna Hawks football on ESPN Radio. Any better? Well, I don't know what else I can do. I think I've got it as high as. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. I got you. Okay. All right. All right. We got to start playing some ball, though. I don't know what's going on here. Yeah. It takes about 2 hours to get here. So. Yeah. Yeah. Me too. I've been sick all week. Yeah, I'm better than I was. Yeah. Okay. All right, welcome back. It's 23 seconds to go in the first quarter. It's been all Blacksburg, but fortunately for the Hawks, they've only kicked field goals. They lead 6-0, and they're set to kick off again. And the Hawks look like they're kind of sleepwalking through this first quarter.
Yeah, and I believe it's a long trip here, but, you know, Gretna is just one big play away from tying this game up and then going back up by a point. So they're definitely not out of it here.
All right, nice kick. This one's going to go to the end zone, taken at the right at the goal line. Hall goes around the left side. He's got some room this time. Got one man to beat. He's to the 50, the 40. I don't think they're going to get him. He's at the 20, the 10, 5. I don't see a flag. It's a touchdown. 100 yards, as close as you can get. And 99 plus on that.
And what did I just say, Stuart? They just need a big play.
Big play, and they just got it.
The ensuing kickoff, they tied right back up, and Gretna has a 101-yard kickoff return, I believe, by Chris Hall.
It has to be less than 100 because if you catch it in the end zone in high school, it's to the 20. So it's got to be 99 plus. He was as close to the goal line as you could get. 7 seconds to go. So it took him 16 seconds to get there, but he made it. And he's returned 3 kicks tonight, so he's probably a little bit tired. All right. Canaris for the extra point. Hawks, unbelievable. They have a chance to be in the lead at the end of the first quarter. Here's the kick. Low, but I think it went through.
And goes it on is top good. Of
the roof. And it rolls off the roof, and somebody catches it. So the Hawks, big play, Chris Hall, 99 yards. They take the lead 7-6. And wow, what a strange first quarter we've had. We'll take a timeout and we'll finish the quarter when we come back. You're listening to Gretna Hawks Football on ESPN Radio. Yeah, okay. Okay. Now we're ready.
You just needed me to say something about they needed a big play.
Okay. All right. All right. Thank you. Give them permission. She's going to start sending you some scores.
Okay.
Duke receives the kick. Hey. Well, there's a little bitty dude.
More fans are still coming in over there.
Welcome back. 7 seconds to go in the first quarter. Hawks now lead it 7-6 after the 99-yard Chris Hall kickoff return. And the Hawks will now kick it off. This one's going to go deep. Taken at the 10 to the 20, 25, cut down at the 26-yard line. On the return, number 18,
Jake Verneil had a pretty good return right there.
Yeah, he got it at the 10, so he got about 16 yards, 17 yards on that. And now the Blacksburg Bruins will take over with 2 seconds to go in the quarter. So we'll get one play here before the quarter ends. Gretna leading 7-6. Shotgun formation, two receivers right, one to the left. And here's the handoff. Number one, Hendricks got maybe a yard. And that's going to end the quarter with our score, Gretna 7, Blacksburg 6. We'll take a timeout. You're listening to Gretna Hawks Football on ESPN Radio. That ain't gonna work.
Josh, number 10.
Welcome back. On second down, quarterback throws short to Williams. He gains about 4, and it's going to be 3rd and about 5 for the Bruins. Ball at the Blacksburg 32-yard line.
And the middle of the field right now is open for Blacksburg if they want it.
All right, quarterback rolling, looking, throwing, and he missed his target. It goes incomplete, and it'll be 4th down. And the Hawks are going to get the ball back, Eric, on a quick 3 and out.
Yeah, quick 3 and out. And the receiver right there, number three, Ethan Goforth, he's coming back to the ball when the receiver's trying to lead him to go farther. So it's just miscommunication right there on the play.
Yep. All right, punting situation. Number eight, who kicks, also punts. And that is Wise. Back deep, Hall and Rosser. No rush. And here's a kick. It's going to fall and take a good Blacksburg bounce. Rosser thought about picking it up but decided not to. Rolls all the way to the 20-yard line. Nice punt there by Wise.
Yeah, good punt. And I believe the net was about 50 on that one, so pretty good punt.
That's real good effort there. And he got a good bounce on that, and it didn't bounce straight. It kind of bounced off to the side, and Rosser thought about trying to pick it up. And, you know, once you do that, you might drop it. So he just decided not to do it. Let's see if the Gretna offense can get going. They've got nothing to show here, although they lead 7-0, but that's for a kickoff return, 7-6.